long time no see, but I have my reasons. You remember the last video I made from that test, my Heycode statements, those expensive speakers, VS the sound test, the BNS E5 vintage speakers, yeah. 85 they were, I think, 85 speakers. And I was a little bit upset, very upset, not a little bit, that these speakers sounded so much clearer than my speakers. And that test will have a second part, because speaker-wise, my friend, speaker-wise, very important. But okay, that will be another video. What happened in the between time? In March, I had my second heart attack, and that was not a... That was a strong heart attack, my second one. And I start, you know, thinking about my life, what to do. I went for a 2 weeks holiday with a dog show, a dog circus in 5 countries. In April, everybody advised me not to do it because it is too close to your heart attack. I said, no, I need space. I need to go away. I need some different environment where I come to be myself again. So I went to that dog show. Fantastic, my friends, fantastic. I had a fantastic time. And I came back and I thought, okay, what now? My heart wasn't in audio all that time, you know. I was thinking what to do with my life, you know. How much more years I have? I had my second heart attack. How lucky I can be the next time, you know, that I, because when you have a heart attack in your sleep, you are gone. So I was lucky again. I survived, and I bought a new car. What's that over there? What's my new car? Unbelievable, my friends. The Kia Soul is gone. I bought a Toyota Avensis, the blue one. We will go outside later in this video, and I'm going to show you what this car is about. Now I am in Simon's house in Joure. I arrived here... yesterday morning I arrived here and we did some tests. I brought I had some equipment for him, but I came here to listen to this thing, my friends. This is a Pioneer 9100. I have contact with many guys, email contact with many guys, and a few times people who know this thing advised me to buy this thing, and I never scored it, but Simon was lucky to score a whole set and the speakers. What were the speakers you?
HPM 100.
So Simon scored this one, the tuner, what you see over there. Yeah, below the Accuphase E202. And he scored a cassette deck, a tape deck, and the HPM 100 speakers.
Yeah, and the reel-to-reel.
Oh, tape, the reel-to-reel deck.
Yeah.
So he scored this Pioneer 9100, and guys, believe me, it's a mint one, and it sounded. Yesterday we played with this thing. We played with the Soundsphere over there, and also we had some other amplifiers connected, and this thing really. Sounded fantastic. It is unbelievable, but I never understand why this thing, because it's only 2x60 watt, eh?
Yeah.
Why it is so expensive, and now I understand the sound is just fantastic, my friends. And we didn't connect the tuner on it, because the tuner is connected to the Accuphase over there. And so, you remember those Ohm speakers? Those Ohm speakers, they are still here, and we will not test. Our test will be only on the Heyco or on the Canton's Ergo RCLs. I sold mine. I now regret it. And what more? Well, I brought this thing for him. Yeah, and a few more other things. And upstairs, I will. This is just a quick video. Upstairs, I'm going to show Simon's room because As you all remember, 2 years ago, I made a video from his collection. So what happened with Simon's collection? Well, it is not more, but he upgraded his collection. It is an astonishing upgrade. This is what he have now. And as you, this one he didn't have. I will make a review from this one later. This one he didn't had. This one you know, I tested in my house.
No, this one. These two are new.
Yeah, I already reviewed.
No, 240 and.
Oh no, this one not. This one is new. This one you already know, the Onkyo. This one I didn't test yet, eh? No.
No.
This one I had before, but it is new in his house. The Akai AM2950. Beautiful, beautiful. This one, unfortunately,
still broken.
It is still broken. He will repair it. Unfortunately, because I never had one, the 5000, the 8500, yeah. 8800.
Yeah.
8000. Unfortunately, okay, above we have some tuners. Yeah. And well, this is the 1010 Pioneer 1010 and the 2275. It was a mint one, but as you can see, he lent it to a friend of him, and that friend damaged the over here. And because it was a mint one, and I said, oh, this is too bad, man, because it was a mint one. And you know, be careful, my friends, who you lend these things out to. And because not everybody see the value of these things. I brought this thing for him. I bought it, as you can.
No, this is my own.
This is your own?
Yeah, I have two now.
So you have two 1200s now?
Yeah, one is a 1200 and the other is a 1200B.
But the 1200 is more
rare.
More have a higher value.
Yeah, it's exactly the same amplifier, but they have some internal changes due to malfunction.
And this is your main, over here, the Marantz.
Yeah.
That is your main, your most beloved receiver.
I absolutely adore this thing.
And John de Recht did the revision.
Yeah. I hate quadro revisions because they are so much work.
And everybody, if you know John de Recht is my, he lives in Rotterdam. And then Simon is a beginner. Repair guy, so Simon cannot repair everything.
No, but he teaches me a lot of things.
And so that's why this thing was revised by John de Recht. If you need a repair guy in the Netherlands, then just contact me. I have his address, his telephone number, okay? And well, this turntable, we will connect later. It is a beautiful turntable, my friends. Beautiful, beautiful turntable. Unbelievable mint. I told Simon, never sell this one, never sell this one. And, what is this?
This is an audioscope. I am so proud to have this one.
No, serious.
Yeah, this is an audioscope.
What the fuck is this, man?
Yeah, this is quite rare stuff.
But what is the function of...
Well, it also has a TV tuner in it. You can actually watch TV on it if you still have the connections, but nowadays TV isn't in the air anymore, so that part of it doesn't work anymore. But yeah, basically you can display the audio graph on the little display there. It's more of a niche thing nowadays.
What's the value of these?
I have no clue. These are Japanese imported.
Okay, so it is rare.
Yeah, you can also see on the lettering that these are Japanese.
So you just bought it because it's rare?
Yeah, I saw it on the Dutch market and I was like, yeah, I gotta have this one of these things.
Okay.
I have been looking out for an audioscope, but I never knew that Sony also made one.
Okay. And over here we have the tape deck, the Pilot. This is the tape deck was with the set, huh? This
yeah.
One, huh?
The
RT1020L, yeah. It is a three motor RT1020L.
Yeah.
It is a 3-head stereo tape deck. Okay. And what are the other reel-to-reel decks over there?
That's a Sony TC-755A.
Yeah, over
and
there,
that's
on the back.
Akai 6:30. I have another one, but that's also lend it out to a friend.
Okay, I hope you will get it.
Yeah,
I'm
never gonna lend both stuff out.
Don't do that, man.
This one was also with the set included. This cassette deck.
Oh, this is the cassette deck with the, what came with the SA9100.
Is the CTF 71?
But you cannot repair this thing. I have to bring it to John the
Left. Yeah, no, I just hate cassette decks to repair.
So I will bring this back to Rotterdam, bring it to John the Left, so maybe he can. Well, I'm sure he can make it work again. 100% sure. If John can do it, nobody can do it, my friends. And this is the rest of your stuff what you have now. So my friends, if you. And I brought the matching tuner from the SA, the Sansui AU 9, yes?
DOD 9.
Yes. And I brought the matching tuner. I already made that a video from that matching tuner. Beautiful tuner, special tuner. And Simon wanted to have that tuner to complete this set. You know, I already sold the amplifier. And okay, so this is in quick what he have. Some of these pieces, I will be here for the weekend. I will review what we will test them out. And I am this thing, especially this thing. You can see this is the only one with a cloth on it. He told me you cannot touch it. He told me watch the video, put the video on my face. Simon told me I cannot touch it because he's afraid for the lettering.
No, that's one. That's this one. It's from 19.
Yeah, this one.
No, the one above.
Oh, this one.
Yeah.
This one I cannot touch.
No. The lettering comes off. The silk screen is very delicate.
Okay. So, but this I never saw.
No, these are extremely rare in the Netherlands.
What is it exactly?
It's a Mans Model 18 from 1968.
Okay.
That was the first receiver ever from.
You gonna sell this thing?
No, I'm just gonna keep this for myself.
You gonna sell this thing?
No, never. That's my pride in my collection. I absolutely adore
this
one.
This is the most beautiful thing you have. I think this. If I would have the choice between this one and the Marantz, the Quadro Marantz 4270, I would go with the black Pioneer,
yeah,
to be honest. And it is just a marvelous, beautiful thing. Beautiful, beautiful. I never had a piece like this. So, this is. Simon is now 21 years old. He's not 20 anymore. And this is his upgrade. What he made in those 2 years. So, he didn't have more stuff, but his stuff is upgraded very much. So, more expensive pieces, yeah. Okay, now we're going downstairs to the cars. I want to show you my car because my friends, I was driving in that Kia Soul, yeah, and that Kia Soul was a very nice car. I was happy with that car, but I start thinking, how much more years do I have? You know, why do you have to be greedy, save money on the bank? Because when I'm gone, you know, when I'm gone, I was thinking, well, you know, I can drive a nice car easy, you know. But, you know, not greedy, but, you know, saving money. Sounded at that time for me important, but, you know, when you have a second heart attack, money in the bank is not important anymore. So I bought a Toyota Avensis, and that Toyota is not suitable to, well, to buy audio stuff. But yeah, you know,
it is a beautiful car.
And okay, if you see this car, you would think, well, if you see how new the car is from the inside, I'm going to show you. This is the inside. It still smells new. It smells like a new car. I bought some new speakers for the back door. doors, because I'm not happy with the sound of the back door speakers. Maybe we can do that tomorrow, to change those speakers tomorrow, maybe. And the hood is like this. It is a pretty big trunk.
Enough size
from audio stuff. It is not that handy as that Kia Soul I had. And if I need more space, I can place these. Let me see how that works. Well, not important. And I'm going to show you my engine. I will tell you more about this car, because this car is very interesting. I'm going to show you the engine of this car. And this car is unbelievable, my friends. And let me see how it works. Yeah. So this is the engine. This is the engine. And this is... Let me see, I have to take...
You can just pull them off.
Yeah. I have to...
Cover.
This is how it is looking. And guys, what you see here is an engine from 2010, because this car is from 2010. So this car is 11 years, in August, 11 years old. But the funny thing about this car, it has only 55,000 kilometers or 34,000 miles. Only 34,000 miles in almost 11 years old. And this is what you have. So Toyota, I can tell you one thing. They are not the most beautiful sportive cars like Audi, like BMW, like Mercedes. But they are the most reliable cars. And when you're young, you go for the appearance.
Close the hood.
Close it?
Yeah.
When you're young, you go for the appearance of a car. And it is more important. You know, I drove some Mercedeses. I had one Mercedes, the 230 Coupe from 82 I had. Yeah, from 82. And some BMWs, a few. Three or four BMWs I had, and this is my first Toyota, my very first one. I bought it for the they are reliable cars, my friends. It is 11 years old, but it has 55,000 kilometers. So I drive 5,000 kilometers a year, so I can drive this car 20 years without having engine problems or mechanical problems. This is Toyota, yeah? And I think maybe some people do not like this model, but I think it is a beautiful car. I'm very happy. It is quiet, and this is my new car, and this car will help me to bring the audio in the future to my house, what I want to film and to score. And now we go to Simon's cars, and I will take over I will take over the cam, and Simon is now going to explain what he have, what kind of cars he have, and he have some special cars. And
I have too many cars.
Because Simon have a new hobby.
Nah.
It is now not only audio but also cars. So. What you see here, this is Simon's car, and let me show you from the back. The tires are very thick tires, 18 inch, eh?
Yeah, 18 inch wheels.
This is a
Alfa Romeo 147 Q2. So this is the biggest and the baddest diesel version you can get. They are exceptionally rare in this country, at least the Q2 version.
Okay, 2008?
2008.
And he bought this beast. And this is
A Alfa Romeo.
A Beast. Yeah. The Alfa Romeo.
166.
166, but the special thing of this Alfa Romeo is the?
Engine.
And you're gonna explain everything about the engine.
First locking rocket. Central locking doesn't work. That's a common issue in these things.
Okay, don't mind the steering wheel because...
I have to replace it because it looks bad. But yeah, it's a 22-year-old car, it's from 1999.
Leather seating, still in good condition.
Yeah, but that's usually the case, but the older Alfa Romeos, they have beautiful seats. They are very comfortable. Now you have to...
First, I'm going to show you this engine. This engine is not normal because the 166 is not that rare. Well, but what is rare?
It is a very rare car. Only 3,000 were sold, and not even 100,000 were sold in the whole world.
Sure.
So yeah, they are.
And how many were sold with this engine?
I have no clue. Most of them over in the Netherlands were diesels.
And the smaller engines?
Yeah, the 2-liter twin spark.
And what you have here is
the 3-liter.
The most expensive engine it was sold with?
The facelift came at the 3.2. But the pre-facelift, it was the biggest version you could get. And personally, I like this one more.
Unbelievable. How many horsepower does this thing have?
225, but it's chip-tuned to 255 or around that. Enough horsepower.
So that's the... And I think James Clark also have this engine in one of his cars.
An older version in a Alfa Romeo GTV V6 from the 1980s. But this engine started out in the end of the 60s. And it's a very famous engine. Used in a lot of Alfas.
Can you switch on the engine, please? Because, guys, if you have sensible ears, please put some ear protection on, because now you will hear this, this sound. Listen to this sound. Yeah, give it a little bit of power. Okay, switch it off. Well, guys, this is the sound of this special engine.
And
believe me or not, this is a special sound. And people who like power engines, this is one of the best sounding engines in the world. And it's the most praised engine. Because I didn't know that, but Simon explained me that. Well, guys, this was the introduction after April, May, June. Well, I put out one video in May. My last video was in May. So this is my first video in 2.5 months. And more will follow, because I have all that stuff to film in this house. And thanks for watching this video. If you like it, put the thumbs up, and for now I say ciao, ciao.